I used to be a huge Halo fan back in like 2004, 2005.
More like Galo.
Welcome back to fucking memories.
Memories all alone in the moonlight. Sometimes I'm...
Lately, I've had the desire to like play in a band again, but it's like it's so fucking hard to like
get find people the, that you even like.
Yeah, first of all, find the right people that like you can kind of get along with, and then also like competent musicians, you know. But then on top of that, like just finding the time to do it. Like I work two fucking day jobs, man. Like I don't have time for that shit.
That's why a lot of those people, you know, are like starving artists, because.
Oh, they're starving even worse now, because...
Yeah. There ain't no thing to play.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to watch you on Skype, Charlie.
Does he do it on
Skype? I don't fucking know. I'm just saying nobody wants to...
BTBam did it on fucking Twitch, and it was awesome.
Nobody wants to see anybody on things when they could just see it live.
I don't mind seeing it on Twitch. I think it's cool. Like, I mean, it's obviously not the same, but it's cool still. Like, it's cool that that's an option for some people. Yeah, Between the Buried and Me did a live stream, like, a couple weeks ago where they played their Colors album all the way through. They did it 2 days in a row, and then on the third day, they opened up the Pro Tools project of their album Colors, and they kind of just walked through it and soloed some stuff, and it was pretty neat. And they didn't charge any money for it, which is awesome. Nice. I mean, obviously, like, you know, on Twitch you can, like, donate and shit, so, like, you know, some of those people were donating and what have you, but, like, it was cool. I thought it was neat. Steel Panther did that, too. They had a live show that you had to pay for, but, I mean, it was, like, $15 or something. Like, it's not crazy. It's cheaper than an actual ticket.
I forgot that Abby's afraid of the heights.
That's why the depth of field changes every time you look down.
That's a profit thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. There might not be a fucking entertainment industry to come back to after all this shit is done and over with. Wait and see. I feel bad for people who like that's their livelihood. It sucks.
Yeah.
It's like the one time in my life where I'm like, well, I'm glad I'm not doing that.
If only I could be back in my old younger self, but with the money I have now.
Yeah, right.
I would probably spend it on stupid shit, so never mind.
Do you have just the money and not the knowledge, or...
Just the money, no knowledge.
Oh yeah, just the money, yeah, I'd probably blow it on a bunch of dumb shit too, probably. But who knows, I don't know.
If I had the knowledge, then yeah, I would just invest it.
I feel like I...
Have you heard of this new startup called Apple?
Yeah, right. That's you'd invest in Amazon.
Yeah.
Like, there you go.
The sucky thing is now I gotta wait until Amazon's actually good to get something.
So fucking what, dude? You make your money back so much.
No, not the money. Like, what if I want my PC parts?
Oh. So you're just resetting everything except your financial situation, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, still, if you had the knowledge...
I got the knowledge.
I want to be clear. In this scenario,
we have the money and the knowledge of right now.
That I would invest in Amazon.
Yeah, I would invest in Amazon.
That's what I would do.
I'd probably invest in both Amazon and...
I'd invest in Amazon, like maybe Google, Bitcoin.
Yeah. Especially Bitcoin.
Yeah.
Like right now, back when I was like that young, Bitcoin was 0.000 cents.
Yeah, so you could buy like 1,000 shares for like $2.
Yeah, and then I would have hundreds of thousands to millions of dollars.
Yeah, exactly. Fuck it, just do what Martha Stewart did and get an insider to fucking tell you what's gonna happen, and then.
But then I go to prison, and I have to make a baking show with Snoop Dogg, and I'm not really the biggest Snoop Dogg fan.
I'm not the biggest Martha Stewart fan, so I guess we're at an impasse.
Well, actually, I'm not the biggest of her either, so We're good.
You're lying. I'm not.
Oh yeah, this is the bridge part. You hold forward. This part is pretty cool though. I like it.
Try not to look down.
It does exactly what you told not to do.
Don't look down.
I think it'd be funny if you look down, then like you automatically lose your balance and fall. That's cool, man. That's cool.
What's going on between you and your friend Owen? Oh my god, Lev, now? It seemed really awkward. Just go!
You'd be right. You fucked me in my hole.
Oh, both of them. I let them in both. That's gorilla style.
That's the forbidden hole. Gorilla style. Are we talking like a jungle gorilla or like a gorilla war fighter guy?
Gorilla style.
Alright. Well, doesn't really answer me, but that's okay. I'm gonna take it as both. Fuck it.
Because I want the parts, and I ain't some little bitch.
I don't get to see her hit the ground, unfortunately.
It sucks. It's kind of what I was hoping for. It was going to be a really long... Ah! Yeah, I'll hug you in a second here. Give me that.
This is pretty fucked. Like, it's some kind of, like, crane or something on, like, the top of a building? Is that what this
yeah,
is?
Yeah, it looks like it fell over.
Or maybe, like, a radio tower or something? Yeah, that's maybe too big to be a crane. What the fuck happened?
I tripped.
Yeah, it looks like some kind of radio tower or something to that.
Radio extent. Kill the radio star.
Yeah.
Radio kill the radio star.
Oh, shit, Lev. It's gonna be okay. Eyes on me. Shit.
Hashtag eyes on Breen.
Neil Breen makes me the scream queen.
Hashtag eyes on Breen.
Wait, was there a note here?
No.
No, okay, that was just a lightning particle effect thingy.
Gotta balance yourself, boy. You gotta balance yourself, boy. I want you to go ball and she's gonna go, ah, and you're gonna go, oh no, I died.
Oh no.
How are you not terrified of this? Don't quote the prophets me. Heights never scared me. It does. The ocean. Dogs.
I got deliberately every single time you look down. I think that's funny.
Almost there. Shit. Hey, look. You can see the hospital now. Oh, fuck.
Wow.
Oh, fuck. Focus on me. I can't do this.
Focus on me, looks down. How could you not be afraid of heights? That's just, like, one, like, misstep and you're dead. That's it.
Yeah.
Like that. Like that, right there.
Maybe it's because I wasn't focusing
on her. You gotta focus on the ground, because that's where...
Yeah, that's where I need to be.
Just reminding myself of the memories I had on the ground. See, if this were permadeath, like, wouldn't it suck to die at this part?
Yeah.
Like, you just, you know, it's an easy part, really, but it's like you just, like, don't do enough of the balance, and then, like, all of a sudden your game is over. You're gonna start all the way over.
Bird poopy! Oh, bird poopy.
I guess I happen to fall right where there happened to be water.
Oh, nice swimming pool.
With stagnant ass water.
See, if only I was the one that hadn't fell, I would have been able to pull me up.
On the bird poopy?
Yep. You fucked us.
Ready? Can I get a minute? We don't have a minute. We have 2 hours to get the supplies. Okay. Bitch.
Weakness.
You got all the sauce, man. You did say earlier that you're the sauce boss or whatever, so...
Yeah, all the sauce is coming back up.
I still remember, like, this is really early on in this playthrough, but there was the one time where you're like, come on. You, like, fucking did, like, a burp like that. It's so funny. Why it makes me laugh so hard, just because I picture like a dude at a fucking county fair playing that song and just throwing up, what's the capital of Illinois, Billy? You're about to drown. there you go.
Yeah, is it Indiana?
No.
Indiana, Illinois. Where's the towels?
And it's not Chicago either.
Yeah, no. Chicago is definitely not. That's the murder capital.
Murder capital of Illinois.
I mean, prove me wrong.
Ooh.
Am I boring you, Taylor?
Oh, fuck.
Am I boring you, Taylor?
Yeah, because you haven't told me what the capital of Illinois is. Billy, have you ever seen The Simpsons?
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, what's the city that they're in?
Jacksonville. This is where I work out.
All right, everybody, get your scorecards ready. Tell us what your score is on the Capitals quiz.
Jacksonville, Illinois.
It's not Jacksonville. It's not Jacksonville.
Is it Quahog? That's the Simpsons, right?
That's fucking Quahog, Rhode Island.
Yeah, it's pretty close. Why can't I work out? Is this not the time?
I gotta get my pump on.
Yeah, I gotta get my pump. Pump it. Download! Pump it. On the radio.
Is that like fucking Maximum the Hormone or something?
No, I think that's the Black Eyed Peas.
Oh, they stink.
Yeah, they do. I don't like Black Eyed Peas. The food or them. Is it Chicago?
I told you it's not Chicago.
Oh, my mistake. Is it, Saskatchewan?
No, you already said that for something else.
That's right. I can't repeat the same joke.
I fucking gave you a hint.
You don't think I understand, Taylor.
I know, but why do you gotta do this?
Why do you gotta do this?
Because then the next fucking 15 minutes of this episode is gonna be like, oh, is it ass? Is it fart? Is it
fart?
Shit? Is it...
Are you giving... Are these clues,
the Simpsons
too?
Is it Bart?
Is it Bart Simpson?
Is it...
Well, you haven't answered my question.
It's not any of those things.
Oh. Well, it's probably Springfield, then.
Yes! You're fucking right! That's your prize. Fuck! Did you read that note?
No, I didn't, because I'm going to go read it at the thing.
That's an important note.
I'm going to go read it at the thing. Fuck!
Rams! Sparrow rats! Fuck! Billy, what did I type in to find that?
What is the skeleton's favorite snack?
Okay, I'll pull it up. It'll be in there.
What is a skeleton's favorite snack? Guess. There's multiple like parodies of it. If you like Undertale and all that kind of stuff. I've
never once played Undertale.
Yeah, me neither. And I nor do I care about it.
I think it's been so like overdone and like talked about that I just don't give a shit to play it.
Yeah.
So I can't. I'm not gonna say if it's, you know, I'm not saying it's a bad game.
I'm saying it's a bad game.
I just have no interest in it.
Yeah.
That's how I feel about Red Dead 2, man. I just don't give a fuck.
Yeah, it's a bad game.
I think it's a bad game.
I gotta get my pump on somehow, Taylor.
The thing that, like, you know, that people seem to never talk about with, like, the Rockstar games is that the gameplay is never that good.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
And the story's only okay.
Yeah, the story's okay.
The code is the same as the Wi-Fi.
You know, I give them a lot of credit, though, because they obviously put a lot of hard work into their games, but, like, I don't know, I've gotten a little fatigued of it. I was never really a humongous fan to begin with, I think.
All right, now I gotta find out what the fucking Wi-Fi is. Normally they have it posted somewhere where everyone can see. One, 1, 2, 1, 8, 7, 9? Yeah, 1, 2, 1, 8, 7, 9.
Whoa. Good lord. That was a swing, dude.
1, 2, 1, 8, 7, 9. Oh, fuck my face.
No, you do it yourself. I'm not your fuck boy.
I'm the one who did it. I'm the winner.
I am the video game boy. I am the gaming boy. Oh, I game because I am a boy.
Is that why you game, Taylor? Yes. Because you were told to?
How many boys do you know of that don't game?
Well, that's just not fair. That's not a fair question.
Every single boy must game. Because boys are conditioned to win.
When I was a young boy, my father fucked me into the city. Or sorry, fucked me into the dirt.
Why so a boy?
Oh, oh, that's what was blocking.
Said I knew from my heart like this. She said I never felt my body.
Ah, watch you.
Always thought a point of love was just to keep growing. To keep growing.
Said Victor and Irina are dead. Every and Miley are missing. And I bet the nest is bigger than we anticipated. I tried to blow him up, but fucking dead, and it is my faulty. Figures that fucking fuck off. Incompetence is worth to kill me.
I always think, I think it'd be cool if they had, like, not even saying that it has to be a game necessarily. I think it'd be cool to actually see some of these scenarios, like, having played out, you know?
Yeah.
Because we always see, like, the long aftermath, like, years down the line.
Yeah, like, people fucking died a long time ago.
Yeah, I think it would have been cool to see, like, you know, even if it were, like, a mini-series or something. You know, you don't have to make it a game, necessarily.
Yeah, just, you know, fucking...
You could make it a game, I don't know. But, like, you know, I just think that would be kind of a cool thing to witness at the very least, is, like, these scenarios that are, like, people are like, oh, shit, like, you know.
Oh, fuck it, poop.
Avery and Blair are bit, they're dead, you know.
I'm just trying to look down, damn. Is that a bear trap? Nope, it's a person.
Cool. That'd be sweet if it was a bear trap in this game.
The guy on the corpse had one.
That's what I fucking said. Stay here. And when I played this, I'm like, the motherfucker had one, didn't he? I think it must have been broken or something.
If you die, I'll be stuck here. Yep.
Understand? because you're going to make it.
Oh, believe me, Lev, I intend on
dying. Immediately.
I am intent on dying here. You know what, also, we never brought it up, but, like, having a braid that long in a zombie apocalypse is a bad fucking idea.
Yeah, it's begging.
Yeah.
Begging to get pulled.
Yep.
And not in, like, a sexy way. Not always, in, like, a gorilla-style way.
I've seen that in the ads. It's always somebody who has one, and they're just getting railed.
Yes, this is what I was.
I remember seeing that, though, and, like, you know, people would make their fucking, like, fake, like, you know, what not to do in the zombie apocalypse, dude. And then somebody would be like, baggy clothes, don't fucking wear them, because then they're easier to grab you.
They're going to eat your pussy, you're not going to like that.
And then, you know, that would be the same exact thing with that braid. Like, if you're running away from somebody, and they're and these are runner zombies, they can fucking grab you. Give you a little nibble, and then you're dead. Like, that's over. It's over for you.
Yeah, even if you kill it.
Yep.
You're still dead.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you gotta wear the loosest fitting clothes.
Don't tie your shoes.
Don't tie your shoes. Have the longest, braidiest hair.
If
they grab your hair, that it will not come undone.
Yeah, if anything, if you could find some scuba diving flippers or clown shoes.
Run in those. It's the easiest.
They're the most comfortable. It is widely known that those are the most comfortable shoes.
And you get the most surface area, most friction.
Most friction, most durable.
Yep.
Either of those two things, clown shoes and or
flippers. If you can find the clown shoes that honk...
Yeah.
With every step.
Because you don't want to surprise them. You don't want to surprise anybody. You want to, like, make sure that your presence is known.
Yeah, because then no one will accidentally shoot you.
Yeah.
And zombies are going to be looking for people, not clowns.
It's true.
So it's the perfect disguise.
You know what I wish they had in this game is I wish they had the donut versions of every character.
Yeah, they haven't done donut.
And, like... As you try to sneak, it's just like you make too much noise.
I'm sorry, guys.
I think that would be so funny.
Abby's still like fucking ripped.
They should have a fucking skinny version for her. Have a fucking like a skin bones fucking version for Abby.
I'm vegan.
Yeah, my dog's vegan too.
He's dead.
He died when he was 3.
I don't know why. The doctors didn't say why, because I didn't take him to it.
He didn't get enough beans.
I like beans.
There was some people fucking make their dogs vegan or vegetarian. It's like, fuck you.
More like vegetarian.
You're gonna kill yourself.
That is a weird place to do it.
Yeah, right in the eye.
Like any sensible person would do it through the cheeks.
Like the ass cheeks.
Yeah, you gotta start with one and then do the other.
No, you just aim it directly across so it goes through both your cheeks.
Yeah, but that's what I mean. Like you do your butt cheeks first and then you do your mouth cheeks.
Oh, yes. I see. I see what you meant.
Yeah. So you do one set, and then you do the other set.
Yeah, if you don't do both sets of cheeks, you're not killing yourself. You're just making it agonizing. Pills here.
I always question how that happened in fucking Fight Club, when he shoots himself in the mouth. Because he puts the gun directly in his mouth, like pointed towards his, like, you know, the back of his head.
Yeah, I'm guessing, like...
But then it comes out his fucking cheek.
My guess is, like, it was slipping the hand at the very end. He just had to believe, like, he had it in.
I guess. Because then that's how he kills Tyler Durden. Like,
by shooting his cheek.
Yeah, and he's got a fucking, like, big gun wound going, like a bullet wound through his fucking head. That would be such a disgusting mask.
That's good.
Yeah.
All right. He fucking decomposed in it. Like, that's gross. How do you know the filters would be good?
You wouldn't.
The filters probably wouldn't be good. I mean, this isn't Metro, so whatever. I guess the filters are fucking perma good.
What the fuck was that, dude?
You fucking god. That guy was Honey Boo Boo.
Oh no, not Honey Boo Boo.
Oh god, no! No! Hello. How the hell did you hit it? That's weird.
No! No! You just got shit, bitch.
I think it would have been pretty cool if they made it so, like, I don't know if they really did that in this game. It's just one extra thing. I understand if they didn't want to do it, but, like, maybe it's because nobody's ever shooting anybody in the leg, but I think it'd be cool if you shot somebody in the leg and then they would, like, limp around them, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe they do do that. I don't know. Because everybody's always going for the kill shot, so it's like, you know, you can't...
Can you not? I was doing something. I was doing something.
Oh my god.
God, you fucking asshole.
Oh my god. Alright, she's gonna tear up my bed.
What's up, Martin Scorsese? I mean, Val. Lorena. Looks like dead.
Don't
guy.
Fucking... Why'd she throw it? Like, hand it to,
yeah,
to
yeah.
The fucking blood, you idiot. I'm pretty sure I said the same thing in my solo playthrough, but it's like, don't throw it.
She's my mamacita. Let me see ya in the pipa.
Did you see her way down?
Oh my god, I'm gonna fuck up. Oh, fuck, I'm dying. I'm dying, can you feel this?
Sorry, don't die. I need you to play this game and me watch you play it. This game that I've beaten 3 times. Billy! Billy! Liking this game so far. Do you like it?
I wouldn't keep playing it if I didn't like it.
That's true.
We've already asked this question.
We've done, yeah, but I just like to hear your thoughts.
My thoughts? Because like THOT?
Because, yeah, there's definitely been plenty of games where we play them and then... I wouldn't say there's any games that we've played necessarily that we don't really like and we stop playing. I mean, like, Neo might be one, maybe. I think after a period of time, I don't really like that game much either, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm not a Neo fan.
I the gameplay itself is alright. The problem I just have is I hate the fucking inventory management. It's so annoying.
But I want to swing.
I think R1. I don't think you can swing here.
It's bullshit.
Yeah, the inventory management in that game is really annoying because you pick up 1,000 fucking weapons and then you gotta like compare it against the shit you already have to see if it's better, and it's like it just took forever and it was annoying. But
alright, is there anybody in the wall?
I don't know, I can't think of a lot of other games that we stopped playing just because we don't like them. I think we just kind of got bored, maybe. I don't know, or didn't feel compelled to go back. I don't know.
Yeah, there's not many games that we haven't finished that we're, you know,
I don't know, we got plenty of games that we haven't finished. I think it just came down to a point where like we didn't really want to keep playing.
Yeah,
not that we hate the game, like Bloodborne, we never finished that.
The black gray of Tolkien sings a large group of infected. Luckily no one's as well as
that would have been it. I wish you actually destroyed this building during this game. That would be dope, but
that'd be too Uncharted-esque.
I know. I'm like, they wouldn't do that. Like, that'd be too over the top. Plus, not to mention, like, this is happening concurrently with Ellie's story.
Yeah.
Like, with what she did. So, like, a gigantic building collapsing. Like, she would have noticed that.
Yeah, that would have been cool, though.
It would have been cool.
Just to see, like, it topple in the distance.
No, they gotta have, like, a fucking...
I knew it!
Abby and Ellie fight on top of the building.
As it's falling down.
And she's like, there's enough Semtex in this building that can blow it out of the... with the push of this button.
Now let's fight!
That's right. No Liquid. One needs to die needlessly. Fucking Abby's arm starts freaking out. It's like, it's me, Joel.
Why does she... No, it's going to be on the other girl who has Joel's grafted arm.
That's true. There you go. That story is actually what happens in the game. Yeah. And it's like 10 out of 10. Everybody is like, yeah.
Totally unexpected. Did not
expect. Totally unexpected, but once I knew what was happening, I loved every... I knew every twist, but I loved it. I'd be down for that fanfic, dude. Hell yeah. That's what I need in my life, is some more fucking Metal Gear-esque stories.
Man, Kojima, why'd you fuck up 5? I know he probably didn't really fuck it
yeah,
up.
Yeah, 5 was
I mean, ass. He did... actually put the story out that was there, and the story that is there, shit.
Yeah, it's not good.
It's got good gameplay.
I didn't even really like the gameplay that much, to be honest. Like, I liked the gameplay more in Ground Zeroes than I did in the full game.
I know it. Why didn't I shoot?
I think it just became too much when they, like, sometimes in games when they give you too many options, like, that's the fucking problem, you know? Because, like, to me, most of the fun from Ground Zeroes came from the fact that you didn't have all these, like, weapons to choose from and shit. Like,
yeah.
You were kind of at the mercy of what you could find in the area, you know? And I thought that was more exciting. Like, Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain is a lot better if you, like, strip down, like, your loadout to, like, very basic shit. At least in my opinion.
See, I'm just a real big story man when it comes to...
Oh yeah, of course, everybody is. Yeah, that game had the shittiest story out of any of them. Like, the fucking portable games had better stories.
So...
Yeah, it was... The story was not good at all. It was such an unnecessary story.
I don't think I played Ground Zeroes. I think
you've
I only seen, watched you.
Yeah, you've seen me play it. Like, even the story in Ground Zeroes is so much better than the whole of...
Oh, is this a Fedora? Is this a Fedoria?
Yeah, like, the Ground Zeroes story is a lot better than the whole of Phantom Pain. Next time I just have a chance, we play the Phantom Pain.
Oh, shit!